Hey there, my name is Sunda, and welcome or welcome back to my channel, where we navigate through college and beyond. In this video, I'm going to be discussing applications for graduate school, specifically about the mistakes you want to avoid when applying. First mistake that students often make is having a damaging personal statement. Personal statements can be really damaging if you include too much information about yourself or if you paint yourself in an unfavorable light, because then the admissions committees are going to kind of assume that you don't really have a sense of professional boundaries, as well as maybe they're not going to think you're able to behave professionally and just come to the conclusion that you might not be the right candidate for their program. In your application, being too vague can also be a problem. So if you make statements like, I want to change the world, I want to help all people, the admissions committees are going to assume that you're applying to their program for a really good reason. So it's definitely important to be more specific about what that reason is, so they can really differentiate you from the other candidates who are applying and ensure that you get accepted rather than rejected from the program. Personal statements are really important because the graduate school committees, they're really going to be using them to determine whether you're the right fit, the right person for this program, as well as they're going to be using it for looking for red flags about who not to admit to the program. So the second mistake that students often make is having harmful letters of recommendation. And we generally assume that reference letters are going to be really great, make us look really awesome, really good, and really desirable as candidates for graduate programs. Of course, it's possible that the people that we choose to write reference letters for us, they might show some indication that we have some undesirable characteristics that may not make us the right fit for graduate school. For example, you want to make sure your reference doesn't say things like you're not a team player or you can't work independently, because those are really important characteristics for graduate school that you definitely need. So if someone is saying things like that, or even not saying it, but it's kind of written in between the lines, then these things are going to really have a big impact on our ability to get into graduate school. And this kind of goes into the second point I want to make about this, is that we want to make sure we're asking the right people to write these letters of recommendation for us. So when applying for graduate school, this generally means that we want to ask professors or we want to ask employers, people who are going to be able to speak to our academic as well as research capabilities, as well as describe our work ethic and personality as well. So a tip that my professor gave me when applying for graduate school was to ask references if they can write a strong recommendation letter. And I think it's important to ask this question because we want to get a sense of whether the person that we're asking is going to be able to recommend us as the best candidate or the most successful, or, you know, just really highly recommend us to the graduate program. We want to make sure the person is not just going to say we're a good candidate or an average candidate, because that's going to be a lot more harmful than good, actually. And of course, we want to make sure that we're not asking our friends or family to write these recommendation letters. It's kind of assumed that our friends and family will write super nice things about us. They'll say we're awesome, we're super nice, we're super smart. However, these people are not going to really be able to speak to our academic and research abilities, and will not be able to kind of determine if we're a good fit for this program or for graduate school. So the third mistake that students often make is not researching the program before they apply. So if you don't spend time learning about the program, then they're not going to want to spend time learning more about you through an interview. Make sure to research the current interests of the supervisor that you're planning to work with. So I've heard of cases where people apply to work with a specific supervisor, and then later they find out that that person has gone on to retirement. And there's also cases where, you know, you apply to a specific supervisor, you know, that supervisor might have been researching this one topic early in their career, but now it's like 20, 30 years later, and then they've completely moved on to studying something else. So you definitely want to know what the supervisor's current research interests are before applying to their program. And this will ensure that there's a fit between you as well as the program and the supervisor. So the fourth mistake that students make is poor writing skills on their application. And this includes spelling mistakes, grammatical mistakes, writing really overly long paragraphs, as well as just having no structure in the essay, specifically the personal statement. So what you really want to do is make sure it's organized nicely, you know, with headings and paragraphs. And you have to remember that these admissions committee people, they have hundreds, if not thousands, of applications to look through. So you definitely want to make sure that they don't have a difficult time reading yours, because that's going to give them a bad feeling. And that's going to, you know, affect their decision making in terms of your application. So just make sure you proofread. And I think this is probably the easiest part of the application to fix if you're having trouble. So even if you're not the strongest writer, you definitely have the advantage of time on your hands, because you can spend as much time as you need in this editing stage of the process. And if you have any friends who are willing to help you out with the editing, then definitely ask them. And if you know a professor, then that's even better. Definitely take advantage and ask your professor to help you, because professors, especially in the program that you're applying to, they're going to have a good sense of what the admissions committee is looking for, and they might even give you some tips about what to include or what not to include in your application. So definitely ask them. And you know, even if you're unsure about asking them, I still recommend it, because you know, the worst thing they can say is no, and then in that case you can just ask someone else. I definitely had a lot of people look over my personal statement, and I think that made a really big difference in getting into graduate school. So here's a quote that I thought was quite helpful in describing who the graduate school admissions committees are looking for their graduate school programs. And this quote is actually from two psychologists who wrote a book about getting into graduate school. "The ideal student, seen through the eyes of graduate faculty, is gifted and creative, very bright and extremely motivated to learn, perfectly suited to the program, eager to actively pursue the lines of inquiry valued by the faculty, pleasant, responsible, and devoid of serious personal problems." So essentially, in the graduate school applications, you want to show the admissions committee that you're the perfect or ideal candidate for the position. Pretty simple, right? So that's quite a long list of characteristics that graduate school admissions committees are looking for. But I definitely think that's really helpful to hear that, because it kind of gives us a sense of what they're looking for and what we really want to highlight and showcase in our applications to increase our chances of getting accepted into these programs. So those were some of the mistakes that students make when applying for graduate school programs. Hopefully you can find these tips useful when going through your own application process and help you improve your chance of getting into your dream school. And if you find my content helpful and want to navigate through college together, then please be sure to subscribe below. I really appreciate it. Thanks so much for watching. Take care and see you next time. Bye!